to sing in front of Swami, you know, aren't you in bliss or something? It's not. I'm a professional. I'm out there to do a job of work. I mean, I was aware of him sitting there, but I know that if I would look at him, I'd just sort of melt, as people did. You know, you saw full-grown men burst into tears at the sight of Swami, so I wasn't going to take that risk. He wanted me to get up and sing and be entertaining, if nothing else. So, but I'd noticed that he was sort of fiddling around with his hand with something, but I didn't like to kind of look too closely, and anyway, I was singing. So when I went up to him, and I was quite happy to see that the rose petals that I'd given him before the concert were still on his feet, which that's why I know they were a little bit swollen. He lifted a gold cloth off this object that had been bought out, which is what he gave me. It's a quite bizarre, psychedelic, carved bird made of glass, orange, pink and purple, and with a sort of light. He said, you have to put it on a light. Well, he showed me, and then the light goes up through the bird. But the important thing was, he said to me, in a very loud, clear voice, like he used to speak a few years earlier, which he hadn't been doing, because he'd been very voiceless, he just said very clearly, "It's the phoenix bird, it's the phoenix bird, it's the phoenix bird," three times. And I mean, I didn't quite know what to expect of that, so I just sort of said something feeble, like, "Thank you, Swami," and backed off and left. And then this bird was delivered to me, because it was too heavy. It was really heavy glass. And I've thought a lot about what that's meant to signify. And, you know, because the phoenix rises from the ashes and keeps coming back, I think probably now, well, I mean, maybe it can be interpreted many different ways. In fact, I wasn't sure if he was talking about me, and that we all rise from the death, or he was talking about himself, because I didn't know that it was only 4 months before he was going to physically leave. But there's always something, whatever he said, there was always a message. He never said anything for no reason, and quite often I've met people who've been spoken to, and then a year later something hits them and they go, "That's what Swami meant." Because it was sometimes quite difficult to understand what he meant. I used to always go on my own to put a party, and then my mother, who was just about 80, she'd been once with me 20 years before with her husband, my stepfather, and he was very thin, very English actually, and in those days you sat on the sand and there was no roof, and it was just too hot for him. And my mother was 10 years younger than him, and she said to me, "You know I will go back, but I know that my husband doesn't want to come here again." He didn't not like it, but it was just too tough for him. He was an elderly man. So when he died, my mother started to come with me, and I must say one of the nicest things when I look back that Swami had done was his grace handling my quite fragile mother, who was still recovering from the death of her husband, because they had 35 years of total happy bliss. And Lord knows, I met so many couples, especially in the Western world, that aren't happy together. And finally I had a mother and a stepfather who were really happy, and she had a hard time. But when he held her hand and took her into the interview room with me, that was an amazing feeling, because, as I said, I don't come from a family of devotees, and the way he was wonderful to my mother makes me feel, even now when I'm talking about it, makes me feel quite almost tearful about it and thankful. My mother used to worry, what on earth's going to happen to Dana? You know, I don't have a family, or I don't have children or anything, which makes me a very good candidate for going around the world singing, because it means I'm not leaving beloved ones. I mean, I've got lots of loved ones, but they're not like, it's not like husband or me sitting at home saying, "Where's this blasted woman of mine going?" So I'm actually free to go and do whatever Swami wants me to do. But he said to Swami one thing that, you know, which I always think, he said it for my mother's sake, and I was very grateful that he said, "Don't worry, whatever happens, I will always look after Dana." It's all a mother ever wants to hear, is that the Lord's going to look after her wayward daughter. But of course, he looks after everyone, but I don't think she was thinking of that then. You know, we are so blessed to even know his name. You know, I feel sorry for anyone that actually has never heard of his name. And one of the things I'm often asked, you know, how do you feel about the fact that Swami's physically not there anymore? And I've got to say, it makes no difference to me, because I didn't live there all the time. Maybe I've heard from some of the teachers at the university, the school there, they found it quite difficult because they were used to seeing him come out every day, and the students were in tears because they were used to seeing him every day. But if you're somebody that doesn't live there, then you have to turn within, and as I said, you've got to see him in every leaf of grass and in everything, the stray dog in the street, he's got to be everywhere. And so it didn't really make much difference to me that he wasn't there. But even as I say this, there's one tiny part of me is actually lying, because there was nothing like being in this packed putta-putty, and everybody would be, I mean, in my case, screaming with agony, the back's hurting, the behind is hurting, the legs are hurting, everything's aching, and you've been there for hours, and maybe somebody from the organisation is talking, and everyone's thinking, oh, for goodness sake, Swami, we just want to see you. And then suddenly he would come out, and all troubles, all aches, everything would go, because he'd kind of float and glide out. Those moments, well, those of us that were lucky to see it, you know, they'll never come again, obviously, but those are things that perhaps you miss, but they were unimportant things in the big scheme of things. He wants all of us to just be the walking messengers of love. But, you know, he's given this us this great world, and we have to look after it. And every time I go to places where I see plastic thrown on the street, or people even eating poison food, by which I mean Coca-Cola, sorry, I shouldn't say this. Don't cancel that off the film. But, you know, things that are just loaded with poison. You know, he's given this world that we should treat our bodies and the world with respect, which is going to take me to the next song. And it's a song I sung for Swami. All these songs I do are the stuff I've sung for Swami. Because we have this world, and we have to look after it and love it. And if we don't, then we are not living his message. I would say, you should never walk past a hungry child, because, or somebody that maybe you think looks kind of awful, because we don't know what the past is. We don't know what we might have been in a past life. I hate to think what I might have been. I often used to think, well, I must have worked in New Orleans in the red light district because I love blues so much. But anyway, we don't know. But so to protect this planet, and I see it all over the world. I go, the beaches in India, strewn with plastic. Russia, everywhere there's plastic, polystyrene. This is killing us all. And don't forget, even in India, it's killing all the cows. They eat this plastic. And at the amazing animal shelter, this place in Puttaparthi called the Karuna Society, they are operating on cows. And they have to take 25 kilos of plastic out of the stomachs of the cows because people throw the plastic away. In London, actually, the other day, I saw somebody walking along, and they had a can of, can't say because it's advertising, and I don't want to advertise it. Poison. And she just drank it, put it down on the floor, and walked on. And I was a few paces behind her, and I was thinking, should I go and tap her on the shoulder and say, excuse me, you've just left that rubbish there. And I'm a coward. I didn't do it. Because you don't know if they're going to turn around and stab you. This is how sad our life has turned into being. You know, we've got gun culture, crime wherever we go. We're really in sort of dark ages. We need Swami so badly. But we must love his planet. We must love especially our enemies, which is kind of the gist of this song. We have to love everything. It's called Love the Love.
Love the love. Love the love. Love the love. Love the love. Love the love. Love the love. Love the love. Love the love of the beloved, love the love of the beloved, love the love of the beloved, oh love the love of the beloved. Take love, don't break love, just make love your goal. So love the love of the beloved, love of the beloved. Love the love of the beloved. Oh, love the love of the beloved.
It's gold in your soul.
So love the love of the beloved. Love the love of the beloved. Love the love of the beloved. Oh, love the love of the beloved.
Once I've finished an album, that's it, and then I move on to make a new production. Sometimes I forget my own lyrics. In fact, often I do. Somebody once said to me, you don't practice enough. It's true. He knows, and I know too much to my shame and horror. I quite often say to people, is there any questions you want to ask me?
Yeah.
Anybody? Somebody said yes, but do you actually want to ask me anything, anybody?
Yeah.
No? Nobody wants to ask me anything. Funny, weird. Have you got a question?
Yeah.
But you've got to shout loud because they've got to hear you at the back.
Yeah. his eyes off you. And we saw that. We saw the love in
him.
Why do you think that he loved you so much?
In case you couldn't hear, this lady here was saying that in 2010, I was conducting the ladies' choir. Apparently, Swami couldn't take his eyes off me. She said, why does he love me so much? He doesn't love me any more than he loves any of you, or he doesn't, or a mass murderer who's sitting in jail. We are all one to him. I think probably he's probably sitting staring, thinking, what have I let this woman on the stage? I've let her loose, my God. And we all know he does have a great sense of humour. I mean, he's extremely funny quite often. A very small example was that one year he sent all his musicians to me, and I'd said to the boys, you know, I'm going to introduce each of you when you come out on stage to do the performance. And they all looked horrified, and they said, no, we can't do it because we're Swami's boys. But when Swami came to the rehearsal a few days later, he sat down on the chair and he said, the first thing she's going to do is introduce you one by one. So he knows everything. And I don't know. I've been told that he looks at me when I'm singing, but I don't really. I have sometimes sneak a little peeking look just to check that, you know, he's not looking furious. Because I have seen people get up and perform and he doesn't sometimes look happy. Mercifully, that has never happened to me. So I don't know. If he was here, we could ask him, but probably better not. It might do something to my ego. It's always a bit of a fragile area there. Anybody got any other questions to ask me? No. Well, when I do these kind of talks in places like Russia, there's about 20 hands go up, and they want to know the weirdest of things. But nobody wants to know anything. Right. Okay. Well then, I think I'm going to finish with a song. I'm just going to tell Russell. This is a song that has something to do with flowers, rose petals. And if any of you have seen me either on video or in Putta Party, you will know that when you're sitting, let's say, in the chair, most people, if they're going to do a performance, go out and get down on their knees and offer him a rose. But I knew that that would be hopeless for me because I've had 4 knee operations in my life. I've just had a new knee put in last year, which is fantastic, actually. But that's a whole other story. But for years and years, I suffered. Since the age of 15, I was caught in a mountain avalanche and should have died one of the many times that Swami had to save me. So in order to not be embarrassing and get down in front of him, because I'd have really looked like a very ungraceful, you know, Swami himself was extremely graceful in everything he did. So the only way I could get around this slight problem was to offer rose petals to him. And I used to throw them all over him. That probably made him laugh, if nothing else. Or I might be able to just gently put them on his feet. But it was always traditionally, even now, even when I've sung and it's just at the samadhi, I still throw the rose petals on. I don't offer a single rose. Because I kind of feel we're all little bits of rose petals. We all just throw ourselves on him. That's what he wants us to do. So the only song I didn't write, apart from the bhajans, that I'm going to sing for you tonight, this will be my last song. It's called Shower the Rose Petals, and I didn't write it, and I really wish I did. And I heard it very late at night after I'd finished a satsang in Chicago, and an elderly lady was playing this late at night on a harmonium. And the moment I heard the words, shower the rose petals, the hairs on my arms went up on edge. And I'd always known about this thing with rose petals and me with Swami, because quite a few years earlier, very early on in my relationship with Swami, for some reason on a ladies' day, there were 4 women, of which I was one of them, who'd been chosen to offer a bunch of flowers to Swami. We were each given a bunch of flowers. And in fact, one of the women was that Hollywood actress, Goldie Hawn. Anyway, the woman who'd given us each bunch of flowers, it was kind of horrible flowers. They were wrapped in plastic. And I wouldn't offer God anything in plastic, but I mean, they were, we call it in England, the kind of flowers you'd buy in a garage. I mean, real cheapo flowers. I don't know where they came from. And they were slightly drooping. They looked awful. And I'd said to the woman who had told us that we all had to give them, I said, I can't give these to Swami. They're awful. She said, no, you've got to. And I was secretly thinking, when she'd gone, I'm not going to do it. And I said to a woman sitting in front of me, I can't give these to Swami. And she said, you be careful, you'll be thrown off the ashram if you don't do what the organisations say. But personally, I prefer to listen to my heart than to listen to anybody in an organisation. Whoops, I shouldn't have said that, but it's the truth. So there we were sitting with this plastic... Sorry, Terry. And there we were, these horrible plastic things. And the three other women before me went up to hand over the bunch of flowers. And Swami had a really long face. He took the flowers and just dropped them to one side. And he took them to the next one, dropped them to one side. And I'm thinking, I'm not giving him these flowers. And I'm not giving him something he's just going to drop to one side. But in the plastic thing of flowers are two roses. And I just ripped all the petals off, put the rest of this plastic nonsense behind me so the woman organizing it couldn't see. And I just went up and dropped the rose petals over him, and he smiled. So it was another lesson to me. You have to listen to your own heart and not listen to anyone else. One of his students once told me that Swami was with about 20 boys, and he said to the boys, go over and sit over there. And they all got up and sat over there, except for one boy who stayed seated there. And later it turned out that Swami had said to this boy, very good boy, I told everyone to go, but you I told in your heart not to go. We have to listen to his inner voice. That's my bit of my message before this song. So Shower the Rose Petals, a song I wished I'd sung and written myself. I've sung it now, I think, two or maybe three times with Swami, and well, I hope you like it because it's the last song I'm going to do for you now. Press it.
Fill your hearts with love.
Thank you very much.